जय श्री माता जी।
ध्यान सत्र में आप सभी का स्वागत है। चित्त को सहस्त्रार पर रखते हुए हम बंधन लेंगे। तीन महामंत्र एवं श्री गणेश मंत्र।
Thank you.
धीरे से चित्त को सहस्रार पर ले जाएंगे। थोड़ी देर ध्यान की इसी अवस्था में बैठेंगे। ध्यान की इसी अवस्था में श्री माता जी की अमृतवाणी ग्रहण करेंगे।
इट इज सच अ ग्रेट प्लेजर टू सी यू ऑल असेंबल्ड हियर एंड which is such a far-fetched place, away from the madding crowd. It's such a beautiful place and which has vibrations. They can't hear you. Now, can you hear me? All right. It's all right now. I selected this place suddenly from a very thick newspaper, American newspaper. The vibrations were just shooting out and I said, what is this coming from where? And there was a little advertisement and I said, this is the place where we have to go. This place has so many vibrations, even in the advertisement. So you can imagine how the guidance comes. It comes from vibrations. And that's how I was here. And this place was selected by the Divine Force. It happened only in one day. Such a miraculous thing to happen in one day. It was taking so much time. for them even to get this. And suddenly, I told them, better get it. It all worked out, and we are now here in the most beautiful atmosphere. Of course, you know that trade unions were driven out, and they came here to hide themselves. They are hiding themselves in this place so that they should not be crushed and destroyed forever. That era is over now. That era of domination, of entering into somebody else's land and occupying it, and considering it to be a great bravery. All that is over now. The human understanding has gone much beyond, and they understand that this is sinful, this is wrong. Whatever we have done was wrong. But those people are no more, and the children and the grandchildren of those children, of these people who were the children of God, they used to think, do not like all that. Because you have no right to take somebody's land like that and occupy it as your own. Of course, the land doesn't belong to anyone. But still, wherever you are born, that's your land, and that land has to be kept with those who are born here, who own it. But this kind of aggression has been going on for ages now. Now the time has come to finish this. Once for all, give up this kind of adventure is to enter into somebody's land or somebody's house and occupy it. But there's another kind of aggression I see now, is that they enter into the minds of the people now, through their talk, through their all kinds of aggressive attitude. And the mind itself becomes a slave. The present times are like that, I think, where people have no freedom to think what is right, what is wrong, and also to take to right things. They have to accept whatever is happening around, whatever is immoral, whatever is destructive. One has to accept, because still I think we do not have sufficient number of sadhus who can oppose all these adventures of modern times. We have another kind where we find these false gurus who aggress, especially America. America is really cursed that way because it had money. So all the crooks of the world came here. Just imagine. To have money itself is not a blessing. They all came here and looted rich people and have made so much money for themselves. This kind of exploitation is very much dangerous, much more, because the mind gets ruined. I've seen many people were ruined, especially many seekers were ruined completely. I hope they are born again and get their self-realization. So seeking is there, no doubt. But all kinds of obstacles have come, all kinds of temptations are there. And so, despite all that, seeking, earnest seeking, honest seeking, they have fallen into traps, which I cannot explain. Why should it have happened? But it has happened. One has to see. It makes you very miserable, unhappy. But still so many are there, you are there, saved now. And in this last judgment, you have risen from that level, this new level, where I am sure you will be able to salvage many more. Each person can salvage at least 1,000 people. And so many of you, if you try that, it would be of a very, very great, very great emancipation for this world which we want to save. So one must know the first duty of every Sahaja-yogi now is to save others, to talk about Sahaja-yoga, to work out Sahaja-yoga in different places. For example, now I was surprised that they are working out on children who are abused. They are also in India, we are working out on various places like prisons, armies. So you can enter into all kinds of activities, you can enter into all kinds of aggressed places and save people. But first of all, I think, is the innocence is under attack. In these Western countries, especially in America, the innocence is under attack. And this is something is very dangerous, because the children get this mutation at a very young age, and what will happen to them? So we have to think of all those innocent children, what we can do for them, how we can save them, how we can work it out. The concern has to now go from yourself to others. You got your realization all right, you corrected yourself, you are absolutely perfecting yourself, all this is there. But now what is to be done? For what is this light enlightened here? It is for others. So now Sahaja Yogis have to live for others and not for themselves. They'll have all the energy, they'll have all the support, and they'll have all the blessings. So we have to live for others. And how do we live for others? It's very simple, is to have concern. Concern about everything. To have concern about the Mother Earth. Concern about your neighbors. Concern about the people who is suffering all over the world. If you read the newspaper, you will be amazed how things are happening, how people are suffering. We have to understand fundamentally that unless and until transformation takes place, we cannot change this world. And you all can transform others. So it's your duty, it's your job टू ट्रांसफॉर्म अदर पीपल एंड टेल देम व्हाट इज डिवाइन लव. लव इज द ओनली वे नाउ वी कैन वर्क आउट. इट इज समथिंग लाइक ए big beacon which will go into this darkness of aggression and which will clarify many places, many hearts, many people. It is a ocean, we should say, ocean of greatness. This divine love is so great and so powerful, at the same time so very gentle, that you can see the nature, how the trees grow. Every leaf gets the sunshine. Every tree has its own position. We have to learn so much from the nature, because nature is bound with that love. Nature has no aggressiveness. It is just under the complete control of the divine love. With this understanding, you should also know that when you are getting to such yogis, what should be your attitude? How you should move? How you should talk to them? How you should understand them? How you should express your love? This is quite possible now. It's not difficult. You should not be afraid, not feel shy, but in a sweet manner, you can talk to them, you can communicate with them, you can tell them. Because this was the time, this was to happen. That's the reason Adi Shakti had to come. Without her, it would not have been possible. All other incarnations were there, but firstly they were only on one chakra, and another one was there to establish themselves with other people around. They did try, they worked it out, but it didn't really work in the real sense of the word. So Adi Shakti had to come, who has all of them with her. They are all with us, all the time wanting to help you to do everything that you want to achieve. It is there where this holy vibrations are with you. For every kind of good work you want to do, any kind of sahaj work you want to do, these vibrations will definitely be there to guide you, to help you, to support you, and to love you. You will be amazed how people, once they start working for sahaj yoga, how they are blessed from every angle. So one has to decide in their own minds that all your dreams have to come true. So only thing what you have to do is to know only that your purpose of life is to spread sahaj yoga. Even now, many sahaj yogis write to me, mother, this is happening to me, that is happening, my father like that, mother like that. But very few. Practically this is over now. They used to write, I should say, all such letters. But now I think they are all being perfected, I don't know what has happened. It's a very unique time where there's light everywhere. The nature is absolutely with you. You can see how nature acts, how it is trying to help you and support you, and how it wants to work out everything for you. It is to be just understood and felt that you are something very special and that you have all the help, every one of you. It's not 1%, 2%. It's not 10% group. It's the whole lot, as if the whole ocean is there to help you. Help you to swim over, to save so many. You haven't seen such an ocean where there is so much depth and all the waves try to save you, to make you float in the realm of joy. All this has happened to you because there is a purpose. It's not just because you have done Pura Punyas and all that. Many people say because of previous life we have got it. That is true. The cause may be that, but the result is that now you are capable of giving realization to people. And this is what you have to do. All the way you have come here in this wilderness, from this wilderness only you will rise and you will bless all the people of the world. Especially America should be blessed again and again, because it's the Virat, it is Sri Krishna's land. Because people will always try to follow, to copy them. Things will improve if you get the, what can I say, the blessings of the various lotuses you have within yourself, no doubt. But what about you doing something? What about you doing something about it? And this is what is very important. Now only thing what you have to do about yourself is to find out about your own activities. What activities you have been doing. You have to find out what have you done and what you can do. When you meditate, you think about yourself. How much you have grown, what have you done, what have you given to others. Whatever you got, unless until you distribute it, it won't increase. That is the fundamental law. And that works. I've seen people who are realized souls, who are very good, who know everything about Sahaja Yoga, but are not yet that much confident, I should say, or that much deep. All this is only possible if you yourself get into creating new sajogis and more sajogis, not for popularity, but for their good and for the good of the whole. I was asked that I should come and stay in America, so America will improve very much. So now here I am. I came here, I stayed here, and I have definitely put in all my attention, because it's a very important, very, very important chakra, which is this, which is America. And this very important country is doing sometimes very stupid things. I would not say that you enter into politics, no. I would not say you get into any opposition and form a group, no. But you also know that you have powers. Even your thought, your desire has powers. Try to experiment with it. Once you experiment, you'll find out that only the attention that you put to these things, it will work out. I'm sure it will work out. It is a country which can definitely help for the emancipation of the whole human beings. But on the contrary, it is going on the other way now. I mean, American culture, I don't understand at all. What is the American culture? Is something. They say something, do something else. There are no proper value system which is accepted by everyone, which is built traditionally from days together. The value system is so convoluted, so twisted, that it's only a sahayogi by his nobility, by his greatness, can disentangle these people. They have funny ideas, and those funny ideas should not deter you, should not stop you, for you know that they are stupid, they are destructive, and they will destroy all the good qualities. You should know that the responsibility of Americans is much greater than the responsibility of any other sadhus, because they are accepted and regarded as the most competent people, as the most effective people by the divine power. Divine power thinks that now you can go all ahead, you can do so much. And let us see, like we have the power and the machinery, but the machinery, if it doesn't work, what's the use of the power? It is useless. So the machinery has to work. And it is working, it is spreading, but we have to double our efforts. I was thinking of doing some sort of a social work here, so that it will go, it will be caught in the eyes of many people. On a subtler level, we have worked. But now we have to work it on the surface. Subtler level, we are there, we have achieved, and we can achieve much more. But we should come out of it and think, what can we do on the surface so that people see what is Sahaja Yoga is and what it can do to people. It's your personal behavior, your collective behavior, your national behavior, all are going to change the atmosphere which is supposed to be superficial, so that that also becomes subtler. I've been saying this in many places, but at this puja I think it is important to say that if you are really facing the Adi Shakti, then you must know your powers are boundless. You have to just assert those powers. It is not a stationary power, there's a movement in it, and there's a right type of a movement. It knows where to enter, how to work it out. Now look at this place. Can you imagine me thinking about a place like this? But I was just had in mind, of course I must say, that we should have some place here because the American Sahaja Yogis didn't have any place to meet. That's all. And see how I got it. But the desire to do all this should be there within your subtler level. And then it works. It works like a magic, I tell you. Now you have faith in yourself and decide about it. I am so very happy that it has been achieved with such ease, unbelievable, with such ease, absolutely nothing great was done. The way we got this was so simple that just like another Sahaja Yogi, the person who was to sell us, came down, so excited, and he just sold it to us, finished. We didn't have to do anything to convince him or to talk to him or reduce the price, nothing. And he sold it out to us. In the same way, whatever on a subtler level you desire, it becomes a terrific force which moves by itself, which knows where to go, how to enter, into which area, and it gets the thing done. It's something we all should experience and work it out with full confidence. It is the love that we have, the concern we have. This is the power that has given us self-realization, and this is the power that is given us this enrichment of achievements. I'm sure all of you who are here will realize how it was done, I mean, so quickly. This is one of the things that should just tell you what we are capable of doing. what we are capable of achieving. And when you think of so many people who are lost in the mire of ignorance, we should really feel from inside that concern and that hanker. How can I help these people? And you will be amazed once you think like that, how this divine power, this force will come in. Forget about petty things and petty problems. They are nothing. You have such a powerful thing behind you. It's true that all this universe was created, everything was created, and then you were created and all that is done. But the greatest thing this power has done is to create Sahaja-Yogis. This is the greatest thing. Those who have knowledge, those who have the pure knowledge, and those who have the divine love in their heart. What a tremendous personality it is. Just think of that and you will get all the opportunities to express that love. May God bless you.
थोड़ी देर ध्यान की इसी अवस्था में निःशब्द ध्यान में बैठेंगे। जय श्री माता जी। दोनों हाथ जोड़कर चित्त को सहस्रार पर रखकर श्री माता जी से प्रार्थना करेंगे। श्री माता जी, आज आपने हमें सामूहिक ध्यान का आनंद दिया, निर्विचारिता प्रदान की, हमें चैतन्य की अनुभूति दी, इसके लिए हम आपके ऋणी हैं। आज का यह ध्यान हम आपके चरणों पर समर्पित करते हैं। श्री माता जी, सत्य की खोज करने वाले सभी साधकों को उनका आत्म साक्षात्कार प्राप्त हो। सारे सहजी भाई बहनों को माध्यम स्वरूप कार्य करने की अनुमति प्राप्त करें, अनुमति प्रदान कीजिए। श्री माता जी, अमृतवाणी में दिया हुआ ज्ञान हमें हमारे जीवन में हर क्षण आचरण में लाने के आशीर्वाद हमें प्रदान कीजिए। श्री माता जी, आपने हमें आत्म परीक्षण करना सिखाया, हमें आत्मा बनाया, हमें क्षमाशील बनाया, इसलिए हम आपके ऋणी हैं। श्री माता जी, कृपा करके हमें करुणामय बना दीजिए, हमें भोलापन प्रदान कीजिए, हमें निर्लिप्तता प्रदान कीजिए। हमारी सारी प्रार्थनाओं का स्वीकार कीजिए, हम सभी सहजी भाई बहनों के कोटि कोटि प्रणाम, कृपा करके स्वीकार कीजिए। जय श्री माता जी। सामूहिक बंधन। जय श्री माता जी।